edge of things, and I think that that's just something that happened in that movement from the kind of double projection to the, you know, high resolution monitors. And I think that's something to think about. I think that black and white is much more kind of intense in its presence here. And I see fewer kind of shades of gray within there. And I think that could either be used for or not work with what you're talking about in your statement.
I got a why did you choose this room?
Just try it.
Use the what?
She had this on a screen before, I really preferred that, but not just because of the double sidedness, but because I think what we're here is talking about this, the edge thing. I think that that kind of uncertainty about what the boundary of what I was looking at in that format seemed to integrate very well with other aspects of the book. This is much more, it's, you know, an animation of the capital A, kind of, I don't know how else to say it. It's like, it really calls attention to that aspect of it, as opposed to this kind of less logical morphing that we saw on the screen before. And that's not the best for it.
One thing I do enjoy about this, though, is that I have to reconcile with both of them simultaneously, and I think that that's something to think about as a structure for another piece, even as you continue to make more of these. But I think even maybe flipping back and forth between the text and the image more often might even contribute to some more kind of cohesion between the two sides, and when I make that unnecessary, this kind of corner.
Is this the same projection that I saw across the hall?
Slightly.
But there. Because I guess the material or the projection, I remember feeling it was quite poetic, and the way I looked at it, almost my response was really poetic. Mm-hmm. When I looked here, I found myself using, I could almost feel the different hemispheres of my brain switching as I was looking from text to image, and I was processing it. And then sometimes they were clashing a bit as I was processing the word and processing the image. Who knows, maybe it's on the same side. But anyway, it was a different cerebral experience for me. So that could have also been the material, it could have been also the softening of the image, or maybe additional editing, but it was, the affect of this was completely different. Mm-hmm. Now we're over there, and it wasn't until I got to sleep, something about sleep, I remember, oh, okay, I just let it sort of wash over me before I was looking at it really good with a very focused, and then I wasn't looking at the other one so focused, I was letting it flow. But it commanded, maybe because of the way the monitors are and everything, it commands my attention in a different way. So that's something to think about, which the record will be this one, basically, is how the media really does change the message.
Seems to be strengths and weaknesses to maybe both attempts at installing this. And so I'm happy to see it done a different way. I kind of noticed a bit of that shift in how I was thinking about it, but I appreciated it, actually. I kind of liked noticing the sort of specificity of the words and how text works in my mind, and then trying to complete the idea with this very kind of abstract, rather ambiguous form, and how, and just how those work together, or don't, how we start specific and then it opens up, or vice versa, it closes back down. I think this work is, you know, it's a big step for you. Considering past work you've done, I think you had a very, you know, a bit romantic ideas in the past, but also maybe a bit more didactic, like a little bit, like you really wanted us to understand what you're saying. Like tried a little too hard to make points and use a language that didn't feel quite like your own though either. Like it was coming out of a particular moment in our history. So I think this is just an interesting step for you, that the work itself is open, but it's for you, it's a step of opening up too. And so I like how the process of you making this is embedded in the work. So it's a very personal work, even though it might feel extremely unpersonal to a viewer right now. So I just appreciated that. I do think the boundary issue here is, it's important, all your works seem to be suffering from that. Other videos may not suffer from that, but yours do. I want the possibilities to feel opened up, and once I feel that black frame around there, it really just sort of contains it. And I don't know if we're going to go talk about that other ones separately or something, but I felt it enough.